This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hi there. Welcome to episode 11, Finding the Slope and Intercepts of a Line. In this episode, we're going to give you an equation, and then you'll need to change it into slope-intercept form in order to find the slope and intercepts of the line. Let's get started. So for this problem, I have kind of a messy-looking line. Negative 2 times the quantity at y minus 3, cut. Reset slide. Going at 5. So for this problem, I have kind of a messy-looking line here. Negative 2 times the quantity y minus 3 equals x plus 12. Now, it seems a little difficult to find the slope and the intercepts of this, so what we want to do is to convert this equation to slope-intercept form. And slope-intercept form needs to look like this. It has to have y completely by itself on the left side equals pretty much everything else on the right. So our goal is to get y by itself. Now you may notice that y is buried in these parentheses and it has a number on the outside, and that can make things really difficult to get y by itself. So if you see y buried in the parentheses, the best first step you can make is to distribute whatever is outside to both of these terms on the inside. This will leave us with something a little bit more recognizable. So negative 2 times y gives us negative 2y, and the negative 2 times negative 3 gives us positive 6. Once again, make sure you remember your signs. It's very easy to make a mistake here. The right side does not change. It is still x plus 12. For our second step, let's look for any terms that contain y. I'll mark them with a red underline. Well, we've got one here on the left, and we don't have any others. Now, we want all of our terms that contain y to be placed on the left side. If there's more than one, we can combine them at this point. Now, right now there isn't, so the equation's good as is. For our third step, let's look for any terms that do not contain y. I'll mark them with a blue underline. Well, we have the positive 6, the x, and the positive 12. And we want to move all of those terms over to the right-hand side, which means that the x and the plus 12 are okay as is, but that plus 6 we are going to have to move. I'm going to mark this in green. Since it's plus 6, we do the opposite. We say minus 6. And now we just bring down whatever we can. The 2y that's in the red underline is not changed. It's still minus 2y. The plus 6 and the minus 6 cancel out. Then we have our equals. And then x and plus 12 minus 6 gives us plus 6. One more step. We might notice we have a number still in front of y, so y is not completely by itself just yet. So now we divide all three terms, the negative 2y, the x, and the plus 6, all over that negative 2. So let's do our divisions. Negative 2y over negative 2, that lets us cancel out the negative 2, giving us just y, which is exactly what we wanted. Now we simply need to simplify the right side. We have x over negative 2 for our next term. Now in this class they don't like you to put negatives on the bottom, so we'll rewrite that as negative x divided by 2. And then our third term, positive 6 divided by 2 gives us negative 3. One more thing. Something else they like you to do in this class sometimes is if you have negative x over 2, realize that there is an understood 1 in front of that x. And that will allow you to rewrite the equation as y equals negative 1/2 x minus 3. And now our equation is in slope-intercept form. Now that our equation is in slope-intercept form, it's going to make it a lot easier to find the slope and the intercepts. The good news here is that a lot of the hard work we've already done. The slope of this line is simply the number that's in front of x, the negative 1/2. No math required right here. We have our answer right now. It's just negative 1/2. Now, to find the y-intercept, it's not that much harder. What we're going to do is we're going to set x equal to 0 and then find y. So set x equal to 0. So everywhere we see x in that equation, we don't put x anymore, we put 0. I'll write that in red. So see where it says x here? We just put 0. And then the rest of the equation does not change. So we'll have y equals negative 1/2 times 0 minus 3. Well, of course, negative 1/2 times 0 simplifies down to 0. So we get that y equals 3. Now, the way they want you to answer this question of the y-intercept is to write it as a point. I'll write it in red here. So you don't just put 3, you put the x value and then the y value. Write it as a coordinate. So our answer for the y-intercept would be 0, 3. Now let's move on to the x-intercept. This one's going to take a little bit more algebra than the last one. We're going to set now y equals to 0. If we want the x-intercept. So everywhere we see y, we now put 0. I'll write that in blue. So our equation now looks like this. 0 equals everything else. Negative 1/2 x minus 3. And now we simply solve for x. Well, we want the x to be by itself on one side and everything else on the other. So let's first move that 3 out of the way. Since it's minus 3, we add 3 to both sides. The negative 3 and the plus 3 cancel out. And then 0 plus 3 gives us 3 equals negative 1/2 x. Now, if you have a fraction times x, you simply multiply by the reciprocal of that fraction. I'll write this in green again. Well, the reciprocal of negative 1/2 is negative 2. So we'll simply multiply both sides by that number. So our equation now looks like this. Negative 2 times 3 gives us negative 6. And then negative 1/2 times negative 2 cancels out and leaves us with just x. Now, once again, we don't simply write that number as our answer. We must write it as a coordinate. So we can't write just negative 6. Instead, we write the x number and then the y number. So our x is negative 6. That's what we just found. And our y is that what we set to 0. So our slope is negative 1/2. Our y-intercept is 0, 3. And our x-intercept is negative 6, 0. Let's recap what we did quickly here. So I started you out with a very tricky looking line and asked you to find the slope and the intercept. Now, it seemed rather difficult to do at first, so something you should do if you see something this crazy looking is to get y by itself. Once you do get y by itself, the slope is just the number in front of x. The y-intercept is the y value you get when you set x equal to 0. And the x-intercept is the x value you get when you set y equal to 0. The slope and the y-intercept are pretty straightforward, but the x-intercept can require a little bit of algebra. Well, thank you all for watching. We'll see you next episode.